Can you use a PA speaker for high-end audio? This question comes to us from Farhad in Bombay, India. Isn't that Bombay? Isn't that Mumbai? Well, anyway, I like Bombay. Sounds like gin. Hey, Paul, I'm trying to create an audiophile sound system for a small-sized wine bar. Can you tell me whether a commercial environment, high-end PA speakers, such as the stage, a company, E20, I have no idea what that is, can replace the large Harbeths or Clips Heresies that when used with a valve power amplifier can make high-end audio? The question is, you know, are the advantages and disadvantages enough to keep me from doing this? Because they're going to be running for 12 hours a day, and I've been told that with a valve amp, you shouldn't bother with PA speakers, even high-quality ones. You should stick to audiophile-grade hi-fi speakers. Well, I think that advice is absolutely correct. You can't have both. PA speakers will never be high-performing speakers, will never be high-end speakers. They, by their very nature, PA speakers do this kind of thing where they lop off the top and the bottom, and their whole intent is loudness. They want to be able to fill a room with loudness, and to be able to do that, unless they're augmented by considerably larger PA woofers, which probably don't go down below much below about 60 hertz, and compression tweeters, and if you, like you might have at a live venue, you're really never going to get high performance sound. So I don't know about using a valve amp. Tubes on a 12 hour a day basis are gonna have to be replaced a lot. I mean, you will get likely better sound depending on what you're trying to do, but I would go with a high performance solid state amplifier, something like maybe our Stellar series, that would give you that tube-like sound, but 24 hour a day reliability that can just play and play and play, and you're not gonna, you know, wear something out. But speaker-wise, I mean, I don't know how big this venue is, but geez, you can fill a reasonable size venue of a coffee shop or a wine bar with multiple pairs of decent speakers. Get some Klipsch. They're not particularly high end, but they're a hell of a lot better than a pair of PA speakers. Klipsch makes a whole bunch of different kinds of speakers, and the higher end you go, you can get close to something decent sounding. You could do a series of very efficient ELAC loudspeakers from Germany. You can do, oh gosh. Well, it really depends on how big this wine bar of yours is and how loud you want to play this music. I mean, I would think when you're sitting there drinking wine, you don't want to have music blasting. You want to have a situation where, you know, like a cocktail room or whatever, where you have really excellent sound. But that's my advice. But let me say something. I'm doing all day here is saying something. No, here's what I'm going to say. Kudos to you, Farhad. Kudos. Why? Most restaurants, 99% of restaurants and wine bars and all that, just they don't give a rat's ass about sound quality. They'll pay attention to their drinks, they'll pay attention to their food, and then they slop up some on-wall speakers, and they're usually Klipsch. I mean, Klipsch goes from really bad dreck to some decent stuff. And I don't mean to pick it on Klipsch, because they do some good things. But my point is, as a consumer of food and wine, I am ever so appreciative on the few times I go into a place and there's decent sound system. I don't have to go say, could you turn that down, please? I don't know what people are trying to accomplish or if they're just trying to fill the space, but once in a while, people get it. So Farhad apparently gets it. He wants the quality of music to be the same quality as the product that he's serving. And kudos, sir. Thank you. I wish more people would pay attention to sound, and it's not just a damned afterthought. You build this gorgeous restaurant, and then you stick some stupid in-wall speakers, little ceiling speakers, and put on XM radio. God, don't do that. Please have some measure of class. Okay. I pissed off the entire restaurant world. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.